Like, we all thought you were co-main event, and then it seemed like just literally an hour later it was changed. Like, you know?
No, I wasn't, to be honest. Like, you know, if I'd have won my last fight, you know, then, you know, I would have said something, but, you know, I two split decision losses and Paddy's won his last two, so I actually thought the only reason why I wanted to jump up the main card when I knew that was happening was because my family up north, they get fight pass, so they can only see the replay on, you know, what is it, Pick TV, after the show's finished. So if I jumped in there, they could see it, they could see the replay. And that was the only reason I didn't care about going to the main event, or co-main event, sorry. We thought it was going to be Paddy anyway, so. And then Paddy, so I never had a problem with it, to be honest, so.
Have you ever dealt with an opponent as vocal and as aggressive as Resident Daddy? He's been saying that quite a lot about you. Is that a new dynamic for you to deal with?
No, I got no problem with that at all. I said before, like, you meet people in this game, but that's just the way he is. But I said, I saw him in the lobby face to face. He never said a thing. You know, he crumbled and put his, he looked to the floor, like a little scared boy. He looked to the floor. And I looked at him dead in the eye. I searched for him, but he never looked. So, and that's what they say, that he's never lying. So he tweeted. It was on like the Instagram. The UFC was doing a Q&A Instagram. So I actually asked him a question. I was like, oh, so you walk by and you hide your face. You know, you look at the floor. I said, but I have my pockets well covered. And he was like, oh yeah, boy. I steal your heart. Whatever you want, steal my heart. No one's broke my heart in UFC, and no one ever will. I'll fight right to death, I said before, so it's got the making of being a great fight. There's a lot of hype here, and there's a lot at stake. So.
Just one more on the situation with Dustin Norman. Was there any hard feelings on your part towards him, or can you completely understand why he wouldn't want to take the fight with you?
Well, I could understand. Like, you know, I'm not stupid. I understand the whole scenario. But then again, if, you know, the last fight had been a win, then, you know, and he'd have said no, then I would have smack talked him. I would have. But you can understand, really. You know, I'm sure all you guys understand, so I'm not any different. But if he really wanted to fight and say, fuck it, you know, I don't care. I'm doing the UFC a favor to step and still fight. Then we would have fought. It would have been us fighting. And then Reza would have got his handbag and just, like, walked off. He'd have been left in the dust, you know, so.
Were you surprised to hear that Duffy picked up a concussion 7 days out from the fight? When's your last sparring session before a fight?
Well, me and my coach, we do like a technical, like, we call it cha-cha, you know, where we put the headgear on the small gloves and just, like, literally move about. We never ever go real hard, but we heard that Stu Duffy got, like, a blow to the head, probably like a freak accident, which caught him, and they found like a shadow in his MRI scan, and that's dangerous, you know. So I thought it was smart for the UFC to pull him, because, you know, it's, you go in there and get a shot to the brain and end up being worse. So
it'd be pretty unusual, though, from your experience, to have a guy throwing a knockout punch at someone who's fighting a week later, all right?
Well, I don't think it was a knockout punch. I've been hearing it was like a they were throwing punches with strikes, like leg kicks as well, and the leg kick was hit with a punch, so it came and sneaked up and caught him. So that's what I heard, but yeah, I think it is a pretty bit unusual for, you know, to be getting knocked out 1 week before the fight, but it is what it is, you know.
Owen, how many memories here from last year, of course, wasn't it? I mean, you were part of that great kind of Irish homecoming. A little bit of pressure maybe on the back of two losses. Does the fact that you're coming home, that you're fighting here in this place, your home, does that imbue you a bit more? Are you a bit more happier going into what could be a pivotal fight for you, given that you're going to have complete support at your back?
I don't feel like I need pressure at all, to be honest. I don't feel like if I lose here, that, you know, I'm going to be caught. Like, the possibilities there, but I'm not saying it's going to happen, so I don't really care. I'm just going to be fighting, that's it. So, he keeps saying this thing that you're fighting for your job, and that's what's keeping him motivated, you know, just for trying to, you know, play that game. That's fine, because I'm coming at him, you know, I'm coming at him straight from the start, and he'll know. Yeah, it's good to be fighting in Dublin. The atmosphere is something special.
Just in terms of what happened with the Reebok stuff, I'm sure it's been, you've heard it a lot of times over. As a guy, you know, from the north, but obviously, you know, home long way from home here. What were your thoughts on that, or did it even bother you at all?
To be honest, I was getting all these retweets and that, tweets about this t-shirt, and so I saw the t-shirt and I was like, what the fuck does this mean? I just never clicked on. I don't know where my brain, unless I'm cutting weight, my head's up my ass, but I never really clicked on, so I just thought, so, fuck that, you know, actually, this is the my coach on me, what does this mean? And it was like, the Northern Ireland bit was out of it, and I just kind of laughed, you know, that was what I thought straight away, but then, but you know, I really don't care, I'm just focusing on the fight, that's still, you know, I'm not trying to get distracted by anything else, even like the whole Dustin Poirier thing happening, I'm still not getting distracted by the fight that I've got here on Saturday night, and that's the only thing I'm focused on.
Hello.
How's it going, mate?
Talk to me about this. We had a whirlwind 24 hours. It seems like, or 2 weeks even. It seems like Norman Parks in the main event, co-main event, and Paddy Hill in the co-main event. But it doesn't matter. You've ended up in the co-main event slot, regardless.
Yeah, it's been crazy, but as I said before, I don't really mind where the fight's at. I'm still fighting. You know, it's me and him fighting on that date, so that's really all that matters. I know it's been a whole, like, the main event's been lost to co-main. I think that's the first time ever in any UFC card has ever happened. Would it be right in saying that?
I think so.
Yeah, but I think so. So they say that it turned out to be that bad, so it'll probably end up being so good after Saturday night. And also, we'll see what happens. I guarantee we'll probably have this chat after the fight, and you'll be saying, oh, that was a great show. Every fight's been finished, and the show was finished in what? An hour or so?
Record time. I think you're going to relish this fight. Rez is a guy that seems like he's going to walk down, he's going to want to put it up to you. Your other opponents may be a little bit timid, having brought out the Norman Parks we saw in the domestic circuit, finishing guys for so long.
Yeah, I feel like this is the, you know, this is a good matchup, you know. The last few matchups has been pretty tough. Not really great performances, but, you know, but I know I'm better than that. That's what matters. I know I'm better. My team knows him better, my coaches know him better than that, so I come into this fight full of confidence. You know, I don't really see a problem where he gives me, to be honest, so I feel like I'm a better striker than him. You know, he says about wrestling and his grappling, I train with some of the best grapplers in the world, I wrestle with some of the best wrestlers in the world, and I'm very hard to hold down and keep down, so I don't think his wrestling will be any problem to me.